the way a conference like this should work ideally, although I know it doesn't work this way, is for you to go to the sessions that you have no interest in. Because most of the time we have a picture in our heads of what it is we like, what it is we do, where our lane is. And often we're correct, but to sit in something that we had no interest in before could all of a sudden spark something that we didn't realize we were interested in. For example, and this was a while ago now in terms of me attending these conferences, and this is why I love what Tony has done with it, is I went into a memoir one. I said, I can't imagine anything worse than this. I hate reading autobiographies. I hate all that. But in the process of sitting in that room, I heard some of the most interesting people talking about things in a cavalier, offhanded way. And I was going, you're writing your memoir, and you're focused on an area of your life that's not necessarily interesting to the public at large, and you're completely ignoring this huge, unique experience that you've had. But it's so close to you that you don't even see it. So that became one of my most favorite areas to attend, simply because I loved watching people talking about how you dramatize areas of your life. And I'm sitting there as a development ex-development exec, now teacher, going, you're not understanding your real story. So as an instructor, one of the things that maybe I'll do with my students, especially my high school students, is have them explore that which they take for granted about their own stories. And that was only because I sat in something that I was not interested initially in. And ever since then, I've tried to find at least one session that's completely out of my wheelhouse, something that I'm going, for example, I'm not a fantasy sci-fi fan, so I've sat in how many of those, and the passion that comes wafting from the speakers and back from the audience to them is almost like a revival meeting. And I'm going, I get what the emotional connection is. This is a genre I don't really understand fully, because it's very mathematical. It's very emotionally disconnected. And I'm like, now I get it. And so if someone's talking to me about a sci-fi story, I now have a much stronger angle to that than I might have had before. And so that's why if someone doesn't like horror, but they're liking romances, they need to sit in on a horror session. Why? Because horror stories have the same tics that romances have. They're scene-oriented, they're bit-oriented, they're mood-oriented. When you're writing a romance, what makes people want to read the next chapter? It's that you have a romantic setting in an unusual area with an unusual challenge. So just by hearing how horror people are focused on setting up a great murder, that's how you set up a great seduction or a great coming into your romantic feelings. It's 'cause romance is suspense. So again, sit in a session that you don't feel is something that you want to learn from. Now, if this is your first session, you're going to want to see a lot of the stuff that you were comfortable with. But still, I would recommend exploring that which you didn't think of, because you might find an incredible, it might open up something for you that you never dreamed was interesting. And isn't that what most writers' careers are based on? How many people actually sold directly into a genre they were expecting to? Almost none. You end up getting your initial in with publishers writing something that you're probably not 100% connected with, but you're doing it for commercial. And then through that, you all of a sudden now have a different insight to tweak your core genre while you're getting a name reputation to where you now have a unique voice, which wouldn't have known how to make unique before.